Anderson Cooper is keeping them honest. AC 360, CNN weeknights, 8 Eastern.
Imagine if the Boston bombing suspects had left a trail of vapors in the air that smelled like a bomb. Vapors that only a specially trained dog could detect.
Stay.
A dog like these, now being trained at Auburn University. Researchers here call them vaporwake dogs.
The point of a vaporwake dog is to detect the vapor of the bomb, if you will, before it's actually placed somewhere where it might explode.
To catch it before that. That is exactly correct. Your standard bomb dog, your explosive detector dog, is primed on looking at an object, a backpack that's placed somewhere. A vaporwake dog's ability is to detect the odor coming off of that backpack on the back of someone as they carry it.
Amazing.
And to follow that plume of vapor.
Auburn University professor Jim Floyd says vaporwake dogs are the ultimate bomb-sniffing dog. They can follow a plume or bomb vapor stretching several football fields, a skill so unique the university hopes to patent it. This video from the university shows a vaporwake dog in action. Once he catches the odor in the air, he never lets up. We did our own experiment at this Alabama mall with the help of Auburn's canine handlers. They give the man in the red shirt a knapsack loaded with explosives inside a pressure cooker, just like the bombers in Boston. Watch as the dog catches a whiff. And just like he's trained to do, when the suspect stops, the dog stops too, then sits down, alerting his handler to the bad guy. In a crowded mall or on a city street, this technique is crucial. These dogs can potentially stop a would-be bomber before it's too late.
You think that if you had a vaporwake dog in Boston, they might have detected the suspects before they were able to place those backpacks down?
Had one of our dogs been in place on that corner with those two guys walking there with those backpacks, I think they would have alerted on.
Their training starts early, even as early as these puppies, which are just about 3 weeks old. At this time, they're held a lot and socialized, and then by the time their formal training starts, when they're about a year old, they're used to people and loud noises, and they don't get spooked so easily.
Auburn has its own breeding program for bomb-sniffing dogs. They rarely use shepherds and traditional breeds, but lean more on Labradors and Spaniels. Paul Hammond, whose company iK9 is working with Auburn to train and deploy vaporwake dogs, explains why.
We need a dog that fits into the public profile, that the public's just going to walk past and ignore as if it was a domestic pet.
Auburn's bomb dogs are being used in airports, on Amtrak trains, and by police departments, too.
What is it about a dog's nose, as compared to ours, that they are able to pick up something like that?
Well, the dog's olfactory system is actually 220 million scent cells, compared to a human's 5 million scent cells. So that sort of gives you a real comparison. You know, so where we might be able to smell a woman's perfume walking by, you know, that the dog will not only smell the perfume, but, you know, the clothes, the materials she's wearing, you know, the shower gel that she washed with that morning.
In addition to vaporwake training, these dogs are also able to detect explosives in the traditional way. Paul shows us by hiding explosives in the tire well of this car.
Good job, atta buddy.
It is a game to the dog, you know. If the dog, you know, thought he was looking for explosives, he probably wouldn't do it.
What may be a game to these dogs could mean the difference between life and death to the rest of us.
Good job, my man.
Randy Kay, CNN, Anniston, Alabama.
Yet another reason why dogs are awesome.